is that Dwayne can run in there and spot a hole. He just runs with his eyes. He runs with his eyes. He sees it and he does it. And he makes offensive linemen look good. Sometimes we don't block them all, but sometimes he gets by them anyway.
He has a chance to become the all-time leader in rushing in terms of one season. He's only 150 or 60 yards away from shattering that record of Leonard Davis. Seems like, again, when the Bears take on Catawba, is because it's a rival game like this and longest rivalry, is there any chance that you'll see, you know, Catawba's not playing the best football they've played all year? There's a chance that they could rise up and give the Bears a tough task.
You know, I would have thought that up until last week. I don't know what happened last week. Mm-hmm. You know, they were at home playing Wise, and Wise had had a difficult time playing with anybody.
Yeah.
You know, since they beat us, they've really struggled. And I thought when we played them, they looked really, really good to me. But they went down to Catawba and beat them 30-6 or something like that. And that was a stunner in my book.
Yeah.
But, you know, the Bears, you always got to be on the lookout. They got nothing to lose. Fake punts, fake extra points, field goals, onside kicks. You got to be ready for anything today.
And this historically is an important game. This might be probably the last home game before the stadium is renovated. And this is the 100th meeting between Catawba and Lenore Ryan. Who's our special guest? They got something to say about that?
We've got a special guest today. This is Mr. Blake Shelton. Brian Shelton. I'm sorry. I knew I'd get that wrong. Blake Shelton's a famous singer, isn't he?
Yeah.
Okay. Brian Shelton. Okay. His great-grandfather played on this field, okay, in the mid-1930s. One of his teammates was Clarence Stasevich, a well-known name, okay? And those 4 years, they were 1-1-2, believe it or not. They had two ties at nothing to nothing against Catawba. Then you got the old man here playing in the 60s. We were 3-1 against Catawba. And then we got the young fellow over here who played against Catawba and was 2-2 mm-hmm. against Catawba in the 1980s. Okay? So there's three generations here representing the 1930s right here. Is this young man 12 years old? Okay? And his great-grandfather played on this field with Clarence Stasevich. And now, behind us, you got the seniors getting ready to write their chapter in the Catawba history today.
25 seniors expected to be talked about here today. It's Senior Day. It is Letterman's Day here between the bricks. And as always, for the 100th time, now it's Lenore Ryan and Catawba.
Go Bears!
Go Bears!
Rivalry that has stood the test of time. One that started in 1907 and continues to this day. For many years, the game was contested on Thanksgiving Day through 1968. It has remained the traditional ending game of the regular season every year since 1973. So today, for the 100th time, it's Lenore Ryan and Catawba.
Yeah, Rolls Royce swerving, famous curving, seeing you out in traffic. We get too worried. 100 racks and 100 still like curse, but I've been selling verses.
One time I lied inside my song, I ain't gon' buy no burke. Homicide on my mind when I slide, I ain't tryna see no hearse. He ain't even died by the gun, took a fake pill, died on perk.
lot of times, Jack, late.
But this is the kind of game, and I said this last week about Martin, it didn't come to pass, but they have nothing in the world to lose. Catawba can go out there and they can play just as hard as they want to. They can run anything on offense. They can fake kicks. They can fake extra points. They can onside kick. They can do whatever they want to do, okay, because they're trying to pull the upset over a team. And if you look at statistically, we're pretty heavily favored from the statistic standpoint. So they can do anything they want to do, you know, to try to win this football game. That always puts you on edge as a coach because you just got to be prepared for it. Now, last week, the same situation came about, but the Bears defensively, boy, did they step up last week from that second quarter on. The Bear defense really stepped up and took charge.
Tabba Ken comes in 5-5 on the season. They're coming off a game last week when they lost to Virginia Wise 30-7. They managed under 50 yards of offense and only 4 first downs. And the Bear defense has been awfully tough here the last 3 or 4 weeks, last month, and been very good. And they have been very good, especially since this win streak started. And that crowd you hear rising is the Bears coming out on the field. They're in their Cardinal helmets, Cardinal breeches with their black uniforms with the white numerals, and the Bears are about ready to go in this one. The crowd is expected here this afternoon. We'll take a break, come back with the kickoff this afternoon. You're listening and watching Lenoir Ryan Football on the Bears Sports Network. Kickoff, Juju Phillips, Jack Huss, cast of thousands. Glad you're aboard. If you're watching or listening, wherever you are, we are thankful that you're aboard the Bear Sports Network this afternoon. As we get set for the Indians and Bears today from Red Stadium on the campus of LR.
You know, Juju, we were talking about statistics a while ago, and I meant to bring this up, didn't get an opportunity there, but, you know, one thing is for sure. Okay, well, this is one statistic you can count on. Dwayne McGee is going to wind up leading the conference in rushing. Okay, he's got 100. They do have to do it on a per-game average because nobody's playing the same number of games. He's at 154. Second place is at 99. He's going to win the conference rushing title.
Yeah, and he has a chance to break LR's all-time record for yards in a season if he could pass Leonard Davis, and touchdowns as well. He has 17 touchdowns this year. I mean, he has had a chance to rewrite LR's record books along with Grayson Willingham, the quarterback for the Bears. And he has had another great year, and he's about one or two in just about every category in passing for LR. So Catawba, I believe that they had won the toss, and they have declined, and they're going to kick it off. And the Bears are going to set to receive it. Wind is pretty – we were down on the field before the game. It picked up a little bit, Jack, but should be ideal conditions here for this game here this mid-November afternoon. Bears are set to receive. Back is for LR is DeAndre Lester, sophomore out of Washington, Georgia. And we are set to kick it. And there is the kick, high kick. It's going to drive the Bears all the way back to the end zone, and that is where we'll see a knee. Ryan Carter downs it in the end zone, and that's where the Bears will start on offense. They're going to the open end here at Barrett Stadium, right to left, as LR going to the, I guess, the south end here, Moret Stadium, the open end here, and they'll start it first. Let's give you the starters on offense. Quarterback Grayson Willingham, the graduate senior out of Matthews, North Carolina. Dwayne McGee, the freshman out of Kissimmee, Florida, will start in the backfield for the Bears. We'll set the rest of the offensive line for you, a young offensive line, as the Bears come out with three wide receivers, two to the right, stacked, and one to the left. Willingham will turn and hand it right side. That's McGee. He'll push forward over the 25 and then haul back for a short gain on the play. Pick up two, second and seven. That front line expected to be Xavier Jennings at left tackle. Bryce Heidinger, the redshirt junior at guard. Blake Jefferson, the sophomore at center. With Isaac Chapman, the sophomore at right guard. And graduate senior Ian Brinson will be at right tackle. Bears come out in a spread. They'll move a couple of tight ends to the left. That's Osborne and Godwin. Willingham takes the snap, hands it left side. McGee running with a hole. He'll get over the 30, close to the 35 where he's pushed back. He's close to a first down on a pickup of about seven.
They're moving the chains. It's going to be a first down. And that was one thing they had trouble with last week, Juju, was we got out in front of McGee, and the lineman didn't get out of his way quick enough. That time they did. They made some nice blocks and were aggressive. McGee was he ran into our lineman several times. Then we started doing the runs without the pulling lineman, and that's when he really shined.
This time shotgun, two receivers right. Play action. Grayson looks downfield, middle of the field, caught. First down. That's Lester running with it into Catawba territory all the way down to the 37. Good play action pass. Willingham finds Lester streaking down the middle of the field, and that's a big LR first down.
Oldest play in football just about on the passing side. You run the inside receiver down the field to back him up, and then you bring the outside receiver underneath him, and he's wide open. Excellent play call. Good throw and catch.
Catawba's defense coming into this game, we mentioned, giving up about 21 points a game. The Bears are going to run a little jet sweep, and this is running with the ball is Parsons. He'll get good yardage as well. He'll get about five down to the 32.
Yeah, that jet sweep has become a little more useful in the offense, and Parsons has really filled in. Kellen Parsons has really, really filled in well for Derek Young. Once Derek went out, he started getting more playing time, and he's really looked good, and he's just a freshman.
Out of King, North Carolina.
6'1", 190. Fair size for a receiver, too.
Sure enough. Three receivers, two to the left. Willingham will throw left side. That's Lester. Stiff arms a man to the 30. Tries to spin out. Does. Breaks a tackle and pushed out of bounds for the first down for the Bears all the way down to the Catawba 25-yard line.
One of the things that Grayson does, and we've talked about it so often, Juju, he's a great play-action passer. He sticks that ball in the belly of Dwayne McGee. That keeps the defense kind of honest, and he pulls it out and gets the ball out quick to a receiver.
Hand off McGee, following his blockers to the right. Catawba comes up and meets him. Short pickup of two goes McGee. Dwayne McGee, who came into this game with nearly 1,400 yards rushing for the Bears. Second down and eight. Bears quickly up to the line.
They're using the hurry up. They've gone to it now. Everybody's spread. There's nobody in the backfield.
Five receivers. Willingham down the middle of the field. Man,
No.
Incomplete. He looked left and then spotted Osborne, the tight end, running down the seam and just overshot him just a bit, went through his hands.
Well, I tell you what, nobody feels worse than Grayson Willingham. That was a touchdown pass to add on to the record. He just absolutely overshot him. If he just kind of lobbed that ball, I mean, there was nobody within 10 yards of the receiver. He just overshot him just a little bit. Cody Osborne was wide open.
I bet you he'd love to have a touchdown too, his senior.
Yeah, absolutely.
Tight end.
Yeah. Three receivers out, running back. Willingham will toss it down the right corner.
Touchdown.
Caught, touchdown. Oh, nice catch. A combat catch for Parsons, I believe.
It is.
And the Bears get on the board on their first possession.
You know, that's something we haven't seen the Bears do in quite some time, dude. You just the isolate one-on-one. Yeah, just isolate. He just ran the fade route into the corner, and Grayson threw the ball, and the defensive back got turned. And when he gets turned and can't see the ball, he's got no chance to play it. He's either going to get interference or it's going to be a touchdown.
And a nifty pass that was just lofted perfectly from Willingham to Parsons, and the Bears score on the first possession. Alba on for the extra point. It is up and good. 12:05 to go. 7-0 Bears. Back with more. This is Lenoir Ryan Football on WSVM Radio.
Celebrate great with Carolina West Wireless. Great new phones and a great customer experience all on our great nationwide high-speed network. Stop by today and get big savings on select Samsung smartphones, like $350 off the Samsung Galaxy S20 and S20 Plus, and $350 off the Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra. The great savings continue with 4 lines of unlimited data for just $35 a month per line. Celebrate great savings and go stay connected wherever your travels take you.
Back here, Juju Phillips, Jack Huss. Bears score on their opening drive. The lead here 7-0, and here is the kickoff. That's Owen. He'll get his leg into it, drives the man back to about the 6, and here we go. The Indians return it across the 20, gets a little bit of a space, and down at about the 25 goes Kewan Pryor out of Cherville, North Carolina. Nice return, and that's where the Indians will start their first possession. They'll come out with junior quarterback Kenny Avent III. He will start number 9. He will be the quarterback for the Indians, the freshman running back out of Tyrea Martin, leading rusher with about 600 yards this season. And, Jack, their offense struggling a bit, averaging 21 points a game with that Bear defense, one of the tops in terms of giving up yardage and points, only allowing 16 points a game this year.
Yeah, and they only got 6 points, I believe it was, last week against Virginia Wise.
Avent throws it over here, the out pattern, it's caught. Pushed out by Percy King by the Bears, but not before. Nice pickup. Little slot receiver that time. I believe that's Lockhart. It's going to be a gain of about 8 on the play.
Yeah, good throw and catch. That was just a little quick out to the slot guy, as you said. And, you know, they're not afraid to do anything today. Like I said, you know, that's what scares you a little bit if you're coaching against them. They have nothing to lose no matter what they do.
This time, Avent hands it straight ahead. No running room this time. Another running back in there, Vaughn Ramsey. He's listed as a defensive back, but a sophomore out of Cokesbury, South Carolina, and the Citadel transfer.
Yeah, people have not been able to run the ball very successfully against the Bears lately. And that number 32, I think, has a lot. Andre Jefferson, I really like him. He's a freshman, and he has really given us a little pop in there and an excellent pass rusher. He'll give us that pressure for the next few years with Luba and Houston graduating.
3rd and 1. They run an option. Avent running to his left has the first down. Ball comes loose. Let's see who comes up with it.
Bears got it.
Yes, indeed.
Somebody
laid a hit. T.J. Blanding on the recovery by the Bears. Bears get the first turnover on the third offensive play of the game. I don't see who made that hit as we see the replay, but Avent on the quarterback keeper running left. Somebody came up and popped him, and the ball popped loose.
Ooh, well, they kind of got a different look there. Might have been number 5. Came from the outside. It was hard to tell on the replay, but it might have been number 5 there that came across and got it.
Sophomore Sedarius Kelly.
That's a caused fumble, or however it's a stat when you cause a fumble.
And the Bears trying to take advantage here. Near midfield, across the middle, complete. Willingham running with the footballs. Carter cuts back again, bumped around at the 30, still moving forward before he is drugged down at the 25. But the Bears came up quick. He found Carter across the middle, and he gets the Bears a big first down pass deep into Catawba territory.
Everybody in America, from the pros down to Little League, run that play. You stick the ball in the running back's belly, and then you hit the slant in behind the linebackers because they can't commit to cover and pass.
This time, straight drop back for Willingham. Grayson looks left, throws, complete. Lester on the reception, drugged down by three Catawba players, but not before Lester gets it all the way down to the 13-yard line for another LR first down.
Boy, great day to be a play caller. Anthony Soto right now, the offensive coordinator for the Bears. If he calls it, it works. You know, you just look out there and you just feel it right now. The Bears can do about anything they want to do in the offensive game.
This time they run a reverse. This is Lester. All kind of room. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And into the land of milk and honey goes Lester. The Bears are on the board once again.
And I tell you what, Coach Jacobs and Coach Soto are pulling out all the stops today. That play was set up beautifully. It looked like run left, run left, run left. And all of a sudden it was a little quick reverse back to the other side. Beautiful play setup.
Blake Jefferson, I believe, the center, was pulling, and he was out there waiting for somebody to block. There was nobody out there. A huge hole, and the Bears executed to perfection. Here's the extra point. Up and good. 14-0 LR with 9:58 to go in the first. It's all Bears early. Stay with us. This is LR Football on WSVM.
Emergencies don't wait. Get to the hospital. Accidents happen. Get well soon. When it hurts to move forward, tackle your pain. Don't make your health wait. See your doctor. Your health means everything.
Jack Huss, 14-0 LR. Jack, if you'd have scripted a better start, I don't know how you could have, the way the Bears have jumped out here in the first 5 minutes.
Well, you know, you've heard me say this before, Juju. You've been around me too long, okay? But, you know, sometimes when the offensive coordinator is the offensive line coach, which Coach Soto is, you're a little more hesitant to be a wide-open kind of play caller. Well, today, Coach Soto, he must have worked with receivers and backs this week, because I tell you what, he is wide open the playbook right now. We've run a couple of wrinkles that they haven't seen, that we haven't seen used all year, and give him a lot of credit. He's got the offensive line playing as good as they've played any time during the course of this year, and his play calling now has stepped up to even match the play of the rest of the offensive team.
I was told in the pregame earlier that, through my vast network of sources, that they might see some other trickerations, but other different kinds of plays here today.
Well,
especially when we get down close to the goal line. Here's a return, breaking tackles. Boy, nice effort that time by the Indians, running back with the wide receiver, Kawan Pryor, out of Cherryville, North Carolina, and he broke a couple of tackles and got close to the 30.
We went right over the top of him. It looked like we had him tackled, but everybody just kind of went over him. He's not a tall young man. I don't know what he's – let's see what he's listed at. Number six, he's listed at 5'6", 155, and played at Burns High School. Lives in Cherryville, but played at Burns High School outside of Cherryville.
So this is where the Indians, who had the ball their first time, coughed it up on a fumble, and the Bears took advantage of the turnover and score. 14-0 Bears. Avent is the quarterback, three receivers out. He's out of the shotgun. Turns and hands it off, not much running room for Martin. Bears stuff him, in fact, probably throwing for a loss of one. That front line for LR led by Amari Houston. You know, Jack, tomorrow I think the all-conference selections will be made in the South Atlantic Conference. Don't be surprised if you see Amari Houston not only all-conference, I think he has a chance to maybe be the defensive player of the year in the SAC.
Yeah, I think Amari Houston has been exactly what you said. Plus, he's up there in terms of sacks. He's in the top five. He is at 5.5 and number 50. Oaks.
There's a pass across the middle, incomplete.
The defensive tackle for Catawba is a half a sack ahead of him, I believe. No, one sack ahead of him. So if he has a good day today, he could move up in the sack standings. But, you know, there's no doubt in my mind he's been the stalwart in there. We knew Luba and he inside were going to be tough, and Houston's just stepped his play up. And you watch him play, too. The enthusiasm which he plays with is evident, and it shows. And I think it feels off to the rest of the team. He and Preston Joseph, John Ross May, those guys have enthusiasm. They really get after it, and they play hard.
Houston's become one of the leaders, came back for this graduate season, this extra season. He's a super senior, has been one of the leaders on defense for the Bears all year. Back to pass, Avan overshot his man. He was shy of the first down on 3rd and 11. Bears get a three and out. Good coverage by the defense. The previous play, Eric Jackson, had a good coverage play in the secondary for the Bears. And so the Indians, they run now, I think, five or six plays. They'll have to punt, and their first drive ended on a fumble. So the Bears should get good field position with a chance to add on here. It's 9-10 to go in the first. LR on top, 14-0. As we said, LR's got to win, and some things got to happen today for LR to get into the postseason. We got one score early on. Game started at 12 o'clock. Barton ahead of Virginia Wise, 27-7, that game of the second quarter.
Yeah, that's a little bit of a surprise. I just checked the offensive line for Catawba.
Oh, they're young, aren't they?
They're all redshirt freshmen with the exception of the right tackle, Demetrius Blackwell. He's a senior. Everybody else starting on the offensive line is a redshirt freshman. The only good thing about that is you got them back. If they've shown any inklings along the way that they can really get it done for them, you got them all back. And then, you know, you replace one spot. But very similar to what the Bears are, except the Bears are a little older. We only lose Ian Brinson on the starting offensive line, and I think on the two deep, he's the only one we lose.
Yeah, everybody else sophomores or freshmen or redshirt freshmen. They got a redshirt junior, Bryce Heidinger. He's probably the next oldest after Ian Brinson. Plays over on the left-hand side. Bears come out on offense, turn it, hand to McGee running right. Trying to follow his blockers. The Indians stack him up, though, pretty good across the 40, up to about the 42. Short pickup of 2, 2nd and 8.
And, again, you saw what we saw last week. We pulled some linemen out there in front of him, and they just kind of get in the way. He's better on the quick hitters. Everybody in front blocks straight away and give him the ball behind him and let him find his way. He's great at that.
We're seeing a good crowd here today at Moret Stadium, and like they do late in the season, the Sunfield is over on the visitor side, and that's where a lot of fans are right now. Here's a pass. It is caught by Lester on the comeback, and he's going to be shy of the first down, though it's going to bring up a 3rd and short near the 50.
Yeah, that was a saving tackle by the cornerback out there. I believe that's number 22. It is Jordan Craig. If he didn't make that tackle right there, Lester made a little move. He was going down the boundary over here for a touchdown.
3rd and short now for the Bears. They line up. They bunch it. McGee in the backfield. They'll put Payne in motion. And here's a handoff. McGee running right. He gets close to the first down. Yep. I don't know if he made it or not.
Let's see where the spot is. The spot's real close. The spot he's got right now, he's made it. Yep.
First down, Bears. The Thomas defense against the rush looks like, Jack, they're really, I don't say selling out, but they really came to play, at least trying to stop McGee running the football.
Difference. That's amazing. That's 50-50 right there.
you can't.
Might be 50.2 or something like that.
Back to pass. Grayson down the field, throws it high and complete. Tried to get it to his receiver, Parsons, running again, that little slant pattern towards the goal line, and a little high, went off his fingertips, could have came down with it,
Nonetheless, it's going to bring up third and six now, stops the clock, 6:20 to go here in the first quarter.
Grayson was kind of caught in between the devil and the deep blue sea, so to speak. He wanted to throw that ball inside, but if he saw the safety coming, which you could see from up here, the safety was coming. If he throws it inside, the safety's probably going to pick that ball. So he had to throw it a little bit to the backside of the receiver, and he couldn't adjust to it quick enough.
Big thanks to our corporate sponsor today. Our game sponsor is Cheerwine. Based out of Salisbury. Pass down the middle. Caught. Touchdown. Again going to Payne. Grayson had plenty of time. Picked out a receiver. Payne was streaking down the middle of the field, and he found him. And he'll get it into the end zone. The Bears are on the board one more time.
And you're going to hear every announcer in the world say, that must have been a busted coverage. I mean, there was nobody down there. Number nine ran down the middle of the field. I think they had two safeties to begin with, and those two safeties kind of split, and one went each side of the field, and the next thing you know, they're giving up 7 points.
21-0. Albaugh's extra point is good, so the Bears score for the third time in the first 8 minutes of this football game. It's LR 21 and Catawba nothing. Back with more. This is LR Football on WSVM Radio.
Back here, Juju Phillips, Jack Huss. Bears have been knocking it out early here in the first quarter. 21-0 in favor of LR as the kickoff rolls out of bounds. So Catawba is going to get their best field position of this game, trailing by three touchdowns at the 35. And right now, Jack, we're looking at scenarios for LR to get into the playoffs. The first thing was for the Bears to play well and win big today. That appears to be happening, and we need the Mars Hill Lions to lose at Wingate. That game starts a little later this afternoon in about 35 minutes or so.
That's a 3 o'clock game.
Yeah, 3 o'clock game.
Yeah.
Actually, an hour and 35 minutes.
Yeah, we started at 1. We'll be 2 hours ahead. We'll be almost done by the time they get through the first quarter, probably.
Yeah.
But you know, again, you know, when you have to, you know, now Catawba gives back 5 yards they got on the kickoff. But you know, when you get in a situation like the Bears are in, the coaching staff already shows me what a great job they've done, because this team is totally focused on this game, because there's absolutely nothing we can do. We can't help anybody. You know, all we can do right now is play this football game and then sit back and wait and see what happens. And then, you know, I doubt there's anything, barring a tie game, which probably you can't happen in college, you know, that's going to change the way the scenario works. If Wingate and Newberry win, they're in, we're out. That's pretty much the way it stands.
There's a running play on first and 15. Stop behind the right at the line of scrimmage. And again, another good play by Bear freshman Andre Jefferson, who hauled down the running back from behind. He came back from the backside and knocked him down. They're going to call it a no gain, second and 15.
You know, you look at that offensive line, they're young, but there's a few. That's a good-looking physical bunch now. I'm looking in there, that's 53 Cameron. Yeah, he's a sophomore, the center, number 53. He's a sophomore listed, so he's not on the two deep as far as a starter anyway.
Second and 15. Avent looking down the middle, tipped away.
Amari Houston.
Yes, indeed. Houston, who's not very big in terms of height, got his hands up and knocked it away.
It's going to bring up third down. And, Jack, when you talk about this game, the Bears coming in, having won five games in a row by an average of 34 points and already up 21-0.
Yeah, the Bears have really stepped it up. I tell you, I've been very, very impressed with the Bears. Defensively, they stepped it up. Offensively, they stepped it up. And Coach Soto has done a great job calling plays, I think. And then you get down defensively, Jamal Brown, he's picked up. We had a little trouble early on, but he seemed to solve a lot of our problems.
Avin back to pass, trying to scramble, look downfield, nobody to find. So he scrambles and runs out of bounds, way shy the first down.
They're not going to go for it, but he's a yard short. I thought he could have made it.
He's 11 yards short.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm looking at the wrong marker. Excuse me, I got excited there.
Yeah, that's okay. I've done that a few times myself. Yeah.
Danny, don't run that one back. I screwed up. Okay, don't run it back.
Our maestro over there, the executive producer,
Danny,
director, Nicosia.
Danny Nicosia. She's a good one, I'll tell you that. We've worked with some great people. I tell you, this year has been really special for me working with these folks that we've had, because I've gotten to know them a little bit better than I used to.
Fourth.
Don't let it roll.
And it's rolling. Nice punt inside the 10, inside the 5, and it rolls down all the way to the 1 yard line.
Jeez. You know how
that's about a 65.
You know how that drives me crazy.
I know.
You know it drives me crazy.
About a 65-yard punt by a Clayton Kyle, sophomore, number 98, gets it down to the 1 of the Bears. That's where their offense will start with 4:41 to go in the first quarter.
And it was about 30 yards in the air. The rest of it was roll. You know, that's why we were not able to run it down.
So Grayson Willingham, who's had a fine first half to a first quarter, I should say. Bears have a chance maybe to tack on another score here, but this time they're going to be way backed up, and Willingham in the gun in his end zone. McGee to his left, and he'll start drop back and complete it over here. Parsons, before he's run out of bounds, they're giving him a lot of space over there, and he just settles in about 10 yards down the field, Jack, and picks up the first down.
Yeah, they're playing zone in the secondary. We don't see a lot of that. Usually we see people playing more man on our corners and then maybe zone in the inside zones. But they're playing man. They're playing zone, so the corners are playing off of them in pretty good ways, and they're just dropping. We're just throwing it underneath. That was really easy right there.
Another play-action pass across the middle. That's Parsons. He'll catch it. He'll get it across the 25, up to the 28. Mark, another first down for the Bears. And Willingham is picking out his receivers pretty well here this afternoon, here in this first quarter.
And, again, they're in zone, so you kind of know where they're going to be. They're not playing man. They're not pressing up on in front of us. And so you kind of know where they are. If you look across there right now, if you're the quarterback, you can see, okay, I know where they're going to be.
Play action again. They'll throw a pass over here right side, trying to break a tackle is Payne. That time Catawba's defense snuffed it out. They came up and knocked Payne backwards. It's going to be a loss on the play, more like a screen pass to the receiver. Going to be a loss of about 6 all the way back to the 23.
Give the defensive coordinator for Catawba a check mark there. He outfoxed us. They came up and played a pressing defense, so when they threw that ball backwards out there for the screen, man, they were all over it. That was just, they outguessed us right there.
Second and long now, 3 receivers. Willingham looking left, back to pass.
When you're in your own end of the field, it's really difficult. Now, as much success as the Bears have had on offense, right now Coach Soto's not probably afraid to try anything. If this were a nothing-nothing game, you'd probably see Dwayne McGee running in a punt.
Time the Bears come out with 4 receivers, no tight ends, running back to the left. That's Cruz of Willingham. He's in the gun.
They're in more of a pressure defense right here.
Back to pass. He'll dump it over here to Cruz. He wasn't looking for the football. Hit him in the back of the leg, it looked like. Kane Cruz was running down the field, but I don't think he expected the ball to be thrown his way.
I don't think he was throwing it to him, if you want to know the truth. They had that drag route. I think Cruz was trying to clear out, and he overthrew the receiver. The inside receiver ran that little drag right behind the line, and I think Kane Cruz's job was to clear it out, you know, run the linebacker out, and then throw underneath him, let him see if he could catch it and run. It looked like Parsons might have been the intended. It's hard to tell.
So that'll bring up the punting unit on the field. Michael Irwin, the senior.
Pretty good win he's kicking into.
Yeah.
I noticed on kickoffs he's having a hard time getting it way down there.
Low snap, but a nice high kick. I don't think this will be returned. And that'll be fielded at the 45, so the Indians get their best field position of the first quarter. We still got 3 minutes and 8 seconds to go here in the first. It's LR 21 and Catawba nothing.
That's what happens when you have a punt roll on the ground, see?
Yeah.
That ball rolled about 30 yards down to our one-yard line. And even though we hit two quick plays real fast, when you know, after that we couldn't do anything. And then we have to punt into the wind. And there you go. They wind up with the ball near midfield.
Catawba came in with this game at 5-5. Had a couple of games that they've had to forfeit because of COVID issues earlier in the season, averaged 21 points a game. Avent back to pass, under pressure, scrambles, throws it complete out near midfield. Good play by the Bear defender that time, TJ Blanding. Not before a 5-yard pickup on the scramble by the quarterback, Avent.
Yeah, give Avent a lot of credit, too. He had to scramble around back there, and finally he kept his eyes downfield. That's what good quarterbacks will do. They may be scrambling. They may be moving in the pocket, but he kept his eyes downfield so he could see in case somebody broke open, and he did.
Our buddy Poole, who's a longtime announcer for Catawba in his final season as the Indians play-by-play broadcaster. He told me before the game, Jack, as Catawba gets a running play for a first down, biggest play of the first half here, 11-yard pickup, maybe a 12-yard pickup. But he's been in radio doing high school and college football for 55 years. That's
Wow. Amazing. That is just absolutely – that's a lot of Friday nights and Saturday afternoons.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's wonderful. I really envy and have great respect for people that work that long in any profession.
First down, the Indians now in Bear territory for the first time. 43, they run an option right. Avent will keep it across the 40, running with the ball. 35, tripped up from behind. Joseph knocks Avent down before he gets 9 on the quarterback keeper. The option, it's second and short now for the Indians.
Avent's got good wheels there. He ran a little faster. I didn't think he was going to be able to outrun us, but he just outran to 7, Delta State, nothing. We would love for Delta State to pull off an upset in that game.
Yeah, West Georgia fifth in the region. A loss would drop them out of the region. 7-0 early again. McRae with the run. He's inside the 5-yard line, and that's about it, goes Martin. And the Bears come up and stop him. Luba up there, and there's a man down for the Bears. It looks like it might be linebacker John Ross May.
Yeah, we don't want to lose him right now. He's playing very well right now, and I like to see him out there. He's got a lot of enthusiasm. He and Preston Joseph, our two linebackers, both have a lot of enthusiasm, and they bleed that over into the defense.
It's like he's going to try to get up on his own power. Nothing. We'll take a quick timeout. Albany State is 3, West Florida 4, West Georgia 5, Mars Hill 6, Newberry 7, LR is 9th. If the Bears get into the playoffs, they got to be among the top 7. And I think everybody in the top 7 are playing today, so there could be some changes. The number one thing, we got to see Mars Hill lose at Wingate later tonight. Here's a handoff running left. Not much running room. The Bears stack him up. That's Martin.
Yeah. Martin's he's their leading rusher. He's averaging 72 yards a game. And that's actually 1, 2, 3, 4. That's fifth in the conference, believe it or not. 72 yards a game is fifth in the conference. And, you know, that's Dwayne McGee is at 154 a game.
That's double, right? Almost double. Martin at almost 600 yards on the ground for the Indians. Now third down, third and goal. Bears trying to stiffen up that defense here. Back to pass. Avent looking left, throwing left. Incomplete.
Oh, that's a penalty. Wow, I don't see how they missed that.
At the Catawba, they're saying the same thing you saw, Jack.
Lord.
Somebody grabbed a jersey, but Bears got away with one, maybe.
That's number 7. I mean, they really.
They addressed him?
Watch. Here's the replay. Watch number 7 grab him right here. Look at him. He's all over him, and he jerks him down to the ground. Go Bears.
That's Alvin James, the man on the coverage. That's the end of the first quarter. We'll take a timeout, come back to start the second quarter with the Bears on top. It's LR 21 and Catawba nothing. This is LR.
car. We'll buy your car. Or a touchdown it.
Field goal is good by the Indians. Clayton Crowell tacks on the first points of the afternoon for Catawba. They're on the board 21-3. And first quarter is now in the books as the first play of the second quarter results in a field goal by the Indians. They get on the board, Jack. Let's run out a couple of stats as we look at things right now. Bears on top here 21-3.
Well, McGee's not off to a great start running the football. 5 carries for 16 yards in the first quarter. But Willingham is 13 of 19 for 183. So, you know, I think probably going in, Coach Jacobs, Coach Soto, and the rest of the offensive staff thought, okay, they're probably going to jam up and try to stop McGee. Let's throw the ball early. And, boy, it's paid off because they have really, really given up a lot in the pass game. And they've done good against the run so far. But let's see what the Bears can do. They're going to run the football. You can count on that. Bears are going to come back out. They're going to make it work in the second quarter like they did last time around. Danny Barton, you know, the second quarter on, we really got it going then.
As you heard Coach Mike Jacobs say throughout the year, they want to be a physical football team and play angry. And running the ball certainly does that, historically even for the Bears. When they run the ball, they have been a very formidable foe. And the Bears leading the South Atlantic Conference in rushing this year, top 10 in the nation. I think about 280 yards a game running the ball today. They have been slowed down a bit, but it's been the passing. And you mentioned about Willingham as we're waiting the kickoff here. He has spread out his receivers, Jack, couple of guys, 5 and 4 receptions in that first quarter. And I believe, is this Lester on the return? He does, from his own end zone. 30, 40, still running, 50, into Catawba territory, and run out of bounds goes Lester. What a nice return of about 70 yards from his own end zone all the way down to the Catawba 38-yard line.
You know, sometimes when you hesitate, he hesitated. He didn't come out right away. And sometimes when you hesitate, it makes the defense kind of slow down, or the cover team. And I think Catawba kind of slowed down thinking, all right, he's not coming out.
Bears 14:09 to go in the second. It's LR 21 and Catawba 3.
Now, the last two drives, let's see if the Bears can overcome this. I don't know if we're in fourth down territory, what he might do right here. But the last two drives, the Bears have had a bad play on first down, a negative play. And that got them behind in the first down distances and that kind of thing. So, you know, let's see if they can overcome it right here.
Send Carter in motion. They got three receivers far side. Ball's near the right hash. Back to pass. Willingham down the middle. Caught. Close to a first down.
And ran backwards.
And got knocked down. Yeah. That is Parsons. It's going to be shy of about 2 yards to the 31, fourth down and 2.
When he caught the ball, see, that's where you got to know you're down in distance, receiver. If he catches the ball and he falls down forward, we got the first down, but he ran backwards. You know, his object was to try to break him, you know, and run the whole thing. You can see it on replay. Boom, right there. All he's got to do is get tackled and go toward the line, and he's got it.
Fourth and 2. They line up. McGee straight behind. Willingham moves under center this time. Fourth and short. Play action, rolling right, Willingham, Grayson looking, tossing, incomplete, in and out of the hands of McGee. So it's incomplete pass, the Indian defense holds, and the offense comes out on the field. The Bears ran a little rollout pass off the play action, and Catawba was ready for it, knocked it away, so it's going to bring up a first down for the Indians, 13:24 to go here in the second quarter.
I thought he might look down the field. Jordan Payne had a step on his man going deep to the corner. I think he just hesitated. I think he kind of wanted to throw it down there because Payne looked like he had a step on his guy running to the quarter. But, you know, the last two series have not been well. After we clicked off three great series in a row, the last two haven't been so hot.
So the Indians come out having scored a field goal on their last series. Avent, the quarterback, Ken Avent, the junior, under center. They run a reverse and running with some space and tackled, a nice physical tackle, but not before the running back with a nice run goes Singleton. Not before he gets a pickup of about 11 and a first down.
That's number 5. That was Sedarius Kelly on the tackle there. It was a good tackle for our secondary. Our secondary has been forced to tackle a lot lately. They've the linebackers and the defensive line have taken care of most plays before they got down the line and past the line of scrimmage.
Bad snap. Avent's going to have to run with it, and he's knocked out of bounds by Jackson. Eric Jackson came up with a shoulder into Avent and just sent him flying into the Catawba bench over there, and it's going to be a big loss of about 6 on the play.
Avent could have avoided that contact if he'd have slid, but he thought he was going to get to the boundary before Eric got there, and Eric said, uh-uh. And it was a legal hit. It looked bad, but it was in a morgue because Avent wasn't really, he was kind of not expecting it. Let's put it that way.
John Ross May still out, the Bear linebacker. Went out with, looked like, a lower leg injury. Dante Young, a senior out of Florida, is in there, number 49, an inside linebacker.
He played a lot of good linebacker this year for the Bears, too.
Here's a wide receiver screen and incomplete pass.
Right through his hands.
Yeah,
too,
right. It went quickly. Didn't have a chance even. Third down stops the clock with 12:09 to go in the second. Third down and 13.
That's something else that's improved for the Bears, too. The Bears receivers have caught the ball much better. Devin Figaro, our secondary coach, has done a great job. Early in the year, we had a lot of drop balls. But if you notice lately, we haven't had that.
So third and long now for the Indians. Three receivers here, far side. One running back. Avent back to pass. Under pressure, scrambling, throwing. Incomplete. Looked like he intended for the tight end. Coming back to the ball was Evan Rojas. And there was all kind of pass rush on. Heat on the kitchen, so to speak. Andre Jefferson, one of those guys, number 32, looked like he had the heat. Also, Willie Lane was in the backfield. So the Bears brought pressure. And that forced Avent to throw it away. And here comes the punting unit.
I think he got outside the box and was able to throw it away because he just kind of flung that ball. It really wasn't thrown toward him.
No.
He knew he was in a problem, and he didn't want to give up a sack. So far, the Bears' sack streak is in jeopardy.
There's the punt. Oh, there's a penalty.
Yep.
That's going to drive the return man all the way back, Ryan Carter.
There's another penalty. We got two penalties on this play. Hey, Carter, you ought to get down, buddy. You ain't going nowhere.
And
he's taking all this abuse for nothing.
Yeah, he returns it all the way back to the 20-25-yard line before he is hit pretty hard and knocked down. But the punter was roughed. Bears went for the block and nearly came up with it. The punter just got clobbered after he kicked it away. And then there was a flag down here at the 10-yard line. So it's like both penalties are going to go against LR.
Yeah, LaKin Nettles, number 14, was the culprit then. He just kept coming flying in there, and boy, I mean, he hit him there. That was the easiest call that Jason Graham, the referee, that's the easiest call he's had all year.
Nettles, a freshman out of Atlanta, Georgia. Bears have 86 freshmen, Jack, on this roster.
Do what?
LR's got 86 freshmen.
Yep. I don't know how old this roster I got that I worked off of. I had 78.
Okay.
Hey, the roster hadn't hardly changed because even on the two deep, it still showed Derek Young on the starting lineup, and he hadn't been played before. But I got 11 juniors, 30 sophomores, and 78 freshmen, or redshirt freshmen. Because we got all these categories now. We got seniors and we got G's.
Yeah.
And both of them, they're in their last year. But some of our seniors could return if they wanted to.
They had that extra year of eligibility.
Mm-hmm. And that's why we've got so many freshmen. That's actually two classes.
Yeah, it is. Sure is. Midfield now for the Indians.
Here's double pass, double pass.
And a double pass over here. It is intercepted by the Bears. Preston Joseph. I mean, he had that thing snuffed out. They threw it left, and then the tight end, Rojas, threw it left-handed all the way over across the field in front of the Catawba bench. And Joseph was waiting, and it was like a volleyball play. He just went up and got it. And he gets it at midfield. Preston Joseph out of Brunswick, Georgia. Talk about veterans, Jack. He is one of those seniors.
Yep.
And he gets the interception, the second Bear turnover the afternoon.
I was watching Coach Walker over there.
That's a weird play.
And Coach Walker was really upset. He was really upset. And you're right. The thing about that, Preston Joseph would never fool. If you looked, there was nobody on that side of the field but him, okay? If that ball gets thrown, you know, well, if he's not over there, it's probably a touchdown. Because it was a well-designed play. It's just that one guy screwed it up for him.
Second and five now for the Bears. Into Catawba territory. 46, Willingham in the gun. McGee behind him. Three receivers, two to the right, one to the far side. Hand off McGee. Trying to find a hole running right. A good play by the defense for the Indians once again. Getting good penetration up front is Luke Sarassi. Number 57, he was in on the stop for the Indians and not for a short pickup. Sarassi is senior out of Apex, North Carolina.
You know, the Bears just haven't blocked as sharp today. We just don't look sharp blocking. We haven't given McGee or Davis or anybody much of a chance. It's been pretty much an all-offensive show with the passing game.
Third and five now, 46 of Catawba. Bears in the gun. Willingham takes the snap, looks left, throws left over here. Caught, run out of bounds. That's Parsons on another reception. He must have a half dozen receptions already here the first half.
I'll tell you what, he's been his go-to guy. And, you know, he plays the position that normally Derek Young would be in, so you can see why he's going that direction. Let's see what his stats say. Parsons caught six passes for 77 yards. Lester, five for 79 at this point.
King, North Carolina freshman. Running right, McGee following his blockers, has a hole, stiff arms, a couple of men to the 30. He tippy-toes out of bounds, not before McGee gets about eight on the play. And the Bear offense now trying to get on a roll here, running the football.
Yeah, that, you know, the Bears are never going to give up on running the football. Just because it's not working doesn't mean we're not going to keep doing it, because Dwayne McGee can break any play at any time.
Second and short. They run it to McGee left side. He's met at the line of scrimmage. He pushes forward. So does that offensive line.
They shoved him. That
yes,
was it.
They did.
The rugby scrum again.
Curtis Feeney among those guys. Ian Brinson, Isaac Chapman, Blake Jefferson, Heidinger, and Xavier Jennings. Veteran group. They're young, but they played a lot of ball together this year, Jack. And that offensive line has really grown up a lot this year.
Yeah.
Throw in Shane Wells as well,
exactly.
Right guard.
You know, Brinson, Jefferson, and Jennings have started every game.
Here's a running play on third and short.
Got the first down.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've started every game. And like you said, you mentioned Shane Wells. He's been in there a couple of times for Isaac Chapman and Heidinger. And Franz has played a lot in his place. So those two guards, the right guard and the left guard, have kind of been back and forth. But the two tackles in the center have been the same people starting every game. And that's a great thing, too, because of the injury situation. None of them have been injured enough to keep them out for any length of time.
6'3", 320 pounds. We're speaking about Ryan Franz out of Blythewood, South Carolina. That's what, outside of Columbia, I believe.
It is.
Yep. First down for the Bears. Play action. Willingham wide open middle of the field. Breaking a couple of tackles is Carter. He'll get it down all the way to the 10-yard line. Goes Ryan Carter. Pick up a 16. And the Bears are on the doorstep again, trying to tack on here, leading 21-3. 8:30 to go here before halftime.
You know, I think Ryan Carter has really impressed me this year. You know, with his size and his ability, he's listed, let's see, at 5'11", 190. He looks a little bigger than that to me, but 5'11", 190 is a pretty good size for a receiver. But he's got some juking ability running the football.
And he's got the ball once again. He takes the pass from Grayson. A little dump-off pass out here in the flat, and Carter will take it inside the five all the way down to the two.
Yeah, the Bears set it up in great position to go ahead and stick that in there. Let's see if they give the ball to McGee down here. Kane Cruz is coming in, and Gunnar Anderson. Okay, let's see what we're going to do here. Generally speaking, if I see Cruz in there and Gunnar in there, I'm looking for some kind of a option play with Gunnar running, wind up running the football.
Speaking of running, veteran coach Curtis Walker was running down to the goal line trying to get a timeout, and they did. So Catawba calls a timeout. We'll keep it right here. 21-3 in favor of the Bears. Just under 8 minutes to go before the half. Couple of scoring updates. South Atlantic Conference, only one game underway besides this one. Barton on top of Virginia Wise, 27-7. In the region, West Georgia leading Delta State 7-0. The big game we're watching, game kicks off at 3 o'clock today. Mars Hill at Wingate. Wingate needs to win that game, knock off Mars Hill. That would allow the Bears, if they could win this game this afternoon, to maybe get into the playoffs as one of the higher-seeded teams in the region.
Bowie State up 14-0 on Fayetteville State in the first quarter. We didn't think that was probably going to, you know, be an upset.
Bowie State in the region, number two, and they're 7-0. I think the only game they lost this year was to an FCS opponent.
Yeah. Well, they've had a and I was just wondering, I don't know if that's a split league or not, if Fayetteville State.
That's CIAA, I believe.
Yeah, if they, see, Fayetteville State's 10 in the region at 8-1. I wonder if that's a conference
championship game.
It is.
Okay. You're right. It is.
Because both of them had good records, and Fayetteville State's in 10th place in the region. Well, that would be a, you know, they would look for a real boost in their standing if they could beat Bowie. And it's at Fayetteville State.
Here we go. Second and goal. Anderson remains in there, and he'll keep it. Gunner running with the football down close to the goal line. He won't get in. The senior out of Alexander Central nearby Taylorsville brings up a third and goal. Ball set inside the one.
Looked like he had a real chance there. I thought when he dove, he was going to cross the goal line, but you got to hand it to Catawba. They knocked it back, and now they come back with Willingham back in there and back to the first unit kind of offense look, third down and goal.
Also checking in for the Bears.
Oh, that's the fullback. Yeah, we use this a couple times. We've seen already
McCray.
This year. Yeah, it's a Y formation.
And
right
a handoff, McGee, and he spins down
he
close
in the end zone.
And into.
No, he's marking it. He's not giving it to him.
No, he's not.
That's the old Y formation. They bring in that big fullback, number 48. They've used him several times. That is.
McCray.
Yeah, Antoine McCray. He's been in there at fullback several times. We've seen that earlier. And they give it to Dwayne and the old. Now, with Jadis Davis down on the goal line last week, they ran that, and Jadis Davis went up over the top. He dove over him into the end zone.
McGee stays in there, I formation. Osborne Willingham on the keeper. Yep. Touchdown. Grayson Willingham on the quarterback keeper. And the Bears get on the board again with 6:38 to go before half. It's LR 27 and Catawba 3. You know, Bears struggled the last couple of series, Jack, but they put it all together on that drive after the turnover. So two of the touchdowns here in the first half by the Bears have come by a way after Catawba turnovers.
And I think that was what Coach Walker was so upset on that interception, on that the trickeration play. I don't think he wanted to use that play at that point in the game. You know, he's not calling the plays. He doesn't even have a headset on. He's relying on his coaches. And, boy, he threw his hat down, and he was really upset after the end of that play. And, you know, he didn't talk to any players. So I know what he was upset about.
So we're waiting the extra point by the Bears as LR leading here 27-3 here on Senior Day. 100th meeting between the Indians. Albaugh's kick is up and good. So he tacks on another, and the Bears – back on the board, 28-3. Stay with us. Back in a flash as we step aside. This is LR Football on WSVM Radio.
Doesn't matter who you are, Everett has you covered. Proud sponsor of the LR Bears.
If you play hard, if you use your feet to chase fitness goals, if you stand all day at work, introducing True Energy Infrared Technology Socks. These may be the best socks you ever wear. Our yarn is infused with infrared nanoparticles. Your body's natural heat ignites these tiny particles, producing infrared energy that improves circulation and stimulates cellular recovery. It's not magic, it's rocket science. The perfect sock for your active life, for fitness, performance, recovery. Proven innovation to ignite your true energy.
Back here, Juju Phillips, Jack Huss. Glad you're aboard if you're listening or watching. Glad you are listening and watching here on the network today. And This game for the Bears, big one for LR, the 100th meeting between these two schools, LR and Catawba. Bears have postseason aspirations, and so far so good. LR is holding up their bargain, leading 28-3. Some games on the board being played right now in the region, West Georgia leading Delta State 13-0, that game in the first half, and we needed a West Georgia loss by Delta State and to maybe help Lenore Ryan's cause. Of course, West Georgia in the region ranked fifth, but they're winning early on in the game 13-0. Here's the kickoff. Fielded at the one, coming out to the right-hand side with some space over the 25 and to the 30-yard line goes return man Will Sheehan. Check that. That's number three, Isaiah Taylor, out of Georgia, and he gets pretty good field position. So that's where the Indians offense, led by Ken Avent III, will start. LR leading here 28-3. Looks like, Jack, after the Bears got off to a good start, they kind of leveled off a little bit, but over the last couple of series, the offense came back awake and now lead at a comfortable margin of 28-3.
Yeah, the Preston Joseph interception was the turnaround play for Catawba. You know, they had things kind of pushing a little bit more in their favor, and boy, when that guy threw it back across the field and it was intercepted, that pretty much put an end to it.
Here's a running play thrown for a loss. Good play for the Bear defense. Coming up to make the stop is defensive end Willie Lane out of Haines City, Florida, as a brother is running back, Jacoby Lane, on the team for the Bears.
And he's a running back with a lot of future, too. We've got three running backs that can four running backs maybe that can really go, and I don't know who they've got in reserve that is being redshirted right now. So the running back position looks pretty strong for the Bears.
Second and 11. Back to pass. Avent looking downfield. Pass is
complete.
Nice catch over there. Diving stop and a reception by the Indians shy of the first down. I believe, yep, that is Will Sheehan on the reception. I believe he was a former quarterback a couple of years ago.
You know what the Bears, you know, talking about what they're going to lose? The biggest thing the Bears are going to lose is really going to have to take some work to get it it's up to this level again is the kicking game. You know, Chase Albaugh, Michael Owen both graduate. Owen was the holder as well as that, and they lose Tyler Keaton, the long snapper on extra points and field goals and things like that. So, you know, a lot of work to be done in the kicking game.
There's a pass. Avent, Bears have it covered, and Eric Jackson had the interception. He was playing center field, and he simply dropped the football, and he knows it.
Wow. I'll tell you what, there's no worse feeling in the world to have a ball right in your hands. I don't care if you're a defensive back or receiver or what. I mean, that ball just floated down right into his hands, and he didn't catch it. That's a terrible feeling.
So Clayton Crowell will now be back to punt it away for the Indians, standing at his own 22. Back to receiver for the Bears, and the return game has been outstanding for LR the last couple of weeks. Carter is back there with Lester, I believe. Lester standing at his own 10. Carter's at his 25.
Ooh, line drive. That's a chance to return here.
And here is Carter. Bobbles it, takes it, 25, and leaps over a man before he's knocked down at about the 34-yard line. So the Bear offense will get really good field position with about 5 minutes to go before the half. LR already leading this game 28-3. Jack, the crowd again for season finale, the last game, we believe, between the bricks before it is renovated starting next week. And a nice big crowd. I don't say it's completely full, but it is near capacity.
And on Catawba's side, too, because they always bring a good crowd with them. But, you know, our special teams have improved. Give a lot of credit to Anthony Baldessare. He's the special team. He coaches tight ends, but he's the special teams coordinator. And that's a real job because you got a lot of special teams to deal with.
Here's McGee running left, and he is hit immediately. That's one thing Catawba's defense has done a good job on today is McGee. He's had a couple of good runs, but nothing, the big breakers. He has not been able to find the big hole.
Yeah.
And that time only a 1 yard pickup.
Well, they're playing zone defense, so they're giving us plenty of throws. And, you know, so far Grayson's taken advantage. He's 17-25 for 228 yards. And McGee's on got 12 carries for 32 yards.
Hand off again.
There
this
you
time
go.
McGee's
there
got a
go.
Hole in the first down.
There you go.
At the 50, at the 40, at the 30. I spoke too soon. 20, 10, 5, and touchdown. Touchdown, McGee. 65 yards. yards to pay dirt and into the land of milk and honey. Wow, what a run.
It's just a matter of time. You know, it's late in the second quarter, but it's just a matter of time. And you see what the difference in that play? There wasn't people, linemen pulling out in front of him. It was just a blocking. We faked a pass and then handed it to him almost like a draw. But the linemen were blocking the guys in front of him, and that let McGee pick his hole. That's what he does best right there. Great job.
So much for being stopped today. 65 yards and a touchdown. And another extra point. 35-3 Bears, 4:15 to go before the half. LR on top here. Stay with us. This is Bears football on WSVM Radio.
Moret Stadium is an iconic part of LR Athletics. Hosting games, tailgating, marching band competitions, sports camps, and graduation ceremonies, the stadium serves as a valued focal point for the greater Hickory area. The time has come to renovate the stadium to allow LR to continue to offer our student athletes, fans, and the community an exceptional experience.
Paramount Kia in Hickory. We want to see you driving a new Kia or, hey, a quality pre-owned Kia. We've got a huge selection of new and pre-owned Kias. You got to get to Paramount Kia in Hickory, Highway 70, ParamountKia.com.
Back here, Juju Phillips, Jack Huss. Bears get on the board again on a great run by freshman sensation McGee for LR. And here's the kick return by the Indians. The Bears knock him down way shy of the 20-yard line. Any doubt, Jack, when you talk about, you know, the postseason awards probably come out this week, South Atlantic Conference votes tomorrow, any chance that Dwayne McGee's not only the freshman of the year but maybe the offensive player of the year?
Well, when I look at the statistics, you know, nobody rushing the ball jumps out except McGee. Nobody passing the ball. Willingham and Redwine, the quarterback from Wise, are the two top. I don't really see anybody being better than McGee as offensive player of the year. Definitely freshman of the year. I don't see how. I mean, that's 18 touchdowns now. He's doubled the guy from Wise. Now, the guy from Wise may have some. Gillespie today updating that score. And Barton 36, Wise 24 in the third quarter. It may be 50-45 in that game. There's some stats piling up there for the quarterback at Wise and Barton. Both of those, well, Barton doesn't count on the conference, but the Wise quarterback's getting some stats, and probably the running back Redwine's the quarterback. He may be getting some big stats up there.
Here's a running play. Not much room for Martin. He's stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Young in on the stop of the Bears, the linebacker. Also stopping inside there was Jefferson, the freshman, Andre Jefferson. So
new quarterback in there, too, yeah. Number 12, Brandon Stewart. He's a senior. You know, that's a good job, I think, by Coach Walker. He's letting the senior get some playing time here. He sees the game slipping away pretty quick. So, you know, let that senior get in there and play some. Avant's coming back next year. He'll have an opportunity to get plenty of playing time then.
Back to pass. And here come the Bears on a blitz. They run a screen pass.
Great play call.
And you're right. And it's a completed pass. Shy of the first down. Tripped up by the Bears. Good play by the defensive lineman, I believe, number 44.
Yep.
It was a good play by Josh Davis,
yep,
defensive lineman, a freshman out of Jacksonville, Florida.
I'll tell you what, that was a saving play, too. He may have gone the distance. They were spread out, and he still had another blocker in front of him. But, you know, it was such a long they were behind the chains a little bit, so it's still, even though it was a good play, there's still another third down and about three.
Third and three now. Ball's at the 32. 31, check that. Quick back to pass, looking down the field. It is caught, first down, 40-yard line.
Good job there. They just spread everybody out and then threw it to the tight end. He just went down between the two linebackers and just turned around. Boom, ball was there. Good throw, good catch, good play call.
Kobe Christensen, redshirt freshman out of Dallas, North Carolina, and a transfer from UNC Charlotte with the reception. Big, tall target as well, 6'3", 230-pounder.
Yeah, that was a very nice throw by Stewart. He just stayed right there in the pocket. He knew where he was going. He was just waiting for him to get down there and turn in between the two linebackers. They were splitting, and he went right in between them.
There's a run right side. Bears come up and meet him. Good play by Eric Jackson of LR. And it's going to be another loss on the play, all the way back to about the 37-yard line. As we said, Eric Jackson in on the stop. Loss of three, second and 13. LR leads this game, Bears 35, and Catawba 3.
I'm just wondering if
final
that
2 minutes
the right
of the
number.
Half.
They got that guy that just carried the ball listed, Von Ramsey, as a defensive back, not a running back.
Four receivers out now for the Indians. They spread them out. Back to pass. Throw it down here. It is caught. Shy the first down. Blanding for the Bears. Pops the receiver out of bounds. Tell you what, Jack, that Stewart's got a nice arm, it looks like.
Yeah, they're running the outcuts against us like people have done. The problem is they got behind a chain. So even with about a 9-yard gain, they're still third down and six. So, you know, the Bears are going to probably be in some type of a zone. You know, in this situation right now with a minute 38 on the clock, what you don't want is to give up the home run ball right here. Make them try to edge it down the field.
See if the Bears bring pressure. They show it. Young and Joseph coming up to the line. They back off, back to pass, and the Bears do get pressure. And a fumble on the play and picked up by the Bears. That's Jefferson down to the 20-15-yard line. I think Luba got the hit. He coughed it up, and that was Jefferson picking up the loose football.
I think you called it perfectly. I think you hit it right on the head. We'll see it on the replay right here, but you hit it just right in my book. That's what I saw.
Third turnover the first half for the Indians. Luba on the hit.
Sack. Jefferson on the pickup.
And perfect. Luba trying to lead him out there blocking-wise.
Yep.
Good team defense by the Bears. They get a turnover, and the offense with a chance to strike again. Jadis Davis out there running back.
The bad thing is the quarterback doesn't make that tackle. Jefferson's got him a touchdown. I mean, he went, nobody else was going to get him. The quarterback, Stewart, made a heck of a play to get him on the ground.
1:26 to go before half. Pitch right. Davis following his blockers has a hold of the five all the way down to the one. He splits that hole. Good blocking on the right-hand side. And Davis took it down to the one-yard line.
Uh-oh.
Here we go. Here's the jumbo. Jumbo formation. Check out this formation for the Bears.
Who's going to be the tailback?
Luba, the tailback. Amari Houston will be the fullback. They practiced it this week, told us in the pregame, watch out for it. Pair of defensive linemen.
Luba's a pretty good athlete. Wouldn't surprise me to see him leap over the top. You don't have a chance to do things like this very often. This is a good thing, but you got to remember this. This will be on Catawba's wall all winter. And, you know, we hadn't talked about this yet, Juju, but next year we play Catawba on October 22nd. And we're at – no, excuse me. We play them on November 5th. It is late, but it's not – well, it'd be the next to the last game because the last game could be the conference championship game.
Okay.
See what they've done. Everybody in this league is playing everybody in that league.
So what you're saying, the SAC is splitting into divisions next year.
Piedmont and Mountain.
Okay.
That'll be the two divisions. We're in the Piedmont. It's toughy. Catawba, Lenoir, Limestone, Newberry, Wingate, and Barton comes into the league for football. Erskine comes into the league for football, and Emron Henry comes in, I think, as a full member.
So the Bears line up in this jumbo formation. Pair of defensive linemen are lining up at fullback and tailback. Willingham hands it to Luba. Touchdown! Dan Luba, All-American defensive lineman. Took a handoff out of the I formation, and here come the flags, and the celebration is on for the Bears.
Well,
Luba went up into the stands and handed the football to the fans, I believe. Yeah. Took his helmet off.
And all the linemen followed him up in there.
Oh, gosh.
I don't know how many penalties we're going to get out of this. We might wind up kicking off from the one-yard line. Let's see if that's going to be one penalty or multiple, because everybody – when Luba ran up the steps and the entire group went with him.
Yeah, Good camera work, guys. Dan went up into the stands, took his helmet off, and said, "Here I am.
Oh,
I just scored my first college touchdown as a defensive lineman running the I formation."
And the funny thing was, he went in standing up. Nobody hit him. The offensive line, that's as clean a hole on the goal line as I've seen all year. I haven't seen the offensive line clean a hole like that all year.
Luba's 280 pounds. I venture to guess that's – I don't think LR's ever had a 280-pound tailback score touchdown before.
I don't think we've ever had a 280. I don't think we've ever had a 280-pound tailback, period.
No. Shades of William the Refrigerator Perry.
Yep.
41-3 in favor of the Bears. Let's see what the penalties are going to be.
After the play, unfortunate conduct on the offense. That penalty will be enforced on the kickoff. The touchdown is good. Lenore Ryan is assigned a team unsportsmanlike. Any further unsportsmanlike will result in an ejection.
In an ejection?
Yeah, so the Bears did.
And they should have. That, I mean, they, you know, they're doing exactly what they should do. I mean, that, you know, it's funny and we enjoy it, but, you know, you just can't have players running up into the stands during the game.
No. Yeah, it was kind of the version of the Lambeau leap there, right? He just went, he didn't have to leap. He just climbed up into the stands in front of David Moose field sign. And the extra point is good, 42-3.
Coach Jacobs has got the white hat coming over to tell him what's going on. And, you know, I'm all in. I'm a former basketball official, but I'm all in with officials on this one. You just can't have that. It was cool and everything about it, but I'll tell you what, it will really give Catawba some, you know, that'll be up on the board for in their weight room, you know, that they let a big old defensive tackle score a touchdown on. Although he's an athlete. I tell you what, he could be a bruising fullback. There's no question about that.
Hickory Ridge High School up in Harrisonburg, North Carolina.
Yeah. Next year, the Bears open on September the 17th. Now, this is a conference schedule. We open at Erskine. Then Carson Newman here at Wise. We go back to Wise. Limestone here at Barton. Then back-to-back, Newberry-Wingate, both at home. And then go to Catawba. And then our crossover game at the end of the year, of course, Erskine's a crossover game, as is Wise, but the game at the end of the year is crossover for everybody. We have Tusculum at home. Now, if we're in the conference championship game, then it could be us against anybody in that league, including Tusculum. But we'll switch, and whoever we were supposed to play in the others, they'll play. So everybody will be playing on that date. But
gotcha.
One of those games will be the conference championship.
I understand. And then the Bears' two non-conference opponents, Virginia State, they open with, and that's followed by a game at Winston-Salem State from historic Bowman Gray Stadium. The Bears make their first appearance against Winston-Salem State there since 1982. And the only reason I remember that, I played in that game and had my first and only interception in my career.
Congratulations.
I was a 60-minute man that day.
Hey, I'll look forward to hearing that story at some point in time. I remember when we played down there.
And we beat them 2-0.
Holy mackerel.
I had an interception in the end zone.
I remember when we played down there I think it was 72. I was working on Saturdays helping them because Coach Painter was bringing me in December, but I was in Gaffney coaching and didn't leave Gaffney until the end of the season.
So you were an offensive analyst
An offensive analyst, that's exactly right. And I would come to Hickory and ride the bus or whatever with the team, and then usually I was up on top of the press box talking on the phones. But that was in 72, I think, when we played down there. Because 73, I was on the staff full time. Coach Painter had retired, and Coach Danny Williams took over, and I was coaching defense then. Boy, you're talking about fish out of water.
Catawba has the ball, and a pass is incomplete. Stewart, the backup quarterback, in there, and falls incomplete. We got 42 seconds to go before the half, trying to calm down after seeing Dan Luba rumble his way into the end zone on a jumbo I formation. The defensive lineman for the Bears, who, let me see, he's not in there right now. I guess he's still getting a breather They have Yelding in at defensive line. Amari Houston back in there for the Bears up front. Second down in 15. Back to pass, Stewart. Lofts it right side. Intended for receiver over there, out of bounds and complete. Blanding on the coverage for the Bears. Third down and long with 36 seconds left. You know, the Bears came into this game. They've been on this winning streak, Jack, and have been winning during this five-game win streak by an average of 34 points. They already have 42 in the books at halftime. And I don't think LR could score 70 or 75 points. But they're on their way to breaking some records here today in terms of points and a couple of maybe players breaking some school records as well here in the first half.
Yeah, the Bears have, you know, they've played really, really well on defense. You can see it here today. We've given up 3 points on that one drive. They had a good drive where they put together about five or six plays where we gave them the ball about midfield. But other than that, they've just the Bear defense has just been phenomenal. And, you know, like I said, you're seeing it today, Juju, and I've seen it the last couple of weeks on the road. We're just playing really, really good defense, and our offense is just, everything we're doing offensively is working. You know, if it's a pass, it's working. You know, we're not making a lot of mistakes. We haven't had a lot of turnovers, not a lot of fumbles, interceptions. The Bears are just doing what they need to do. The kicking game's solid. And I think now out the kicker, the punter at Wingate, I'd have to hand it to him. The punter at Wingate, he's phenomenal. He's probably the best punter in the league. I think Michael Owen's right up there, but I think that kid at Wingate, he's very, very impressive. He's an NFL-type kicker, I think. And then Alba's probably the best place kicker, but there's some good place kickers in the league. But we're just, you know, everything else we're doing right now is just working. And you know, it's just hard to beat somebody when everything's going like that.
It has worked to almost near perfection here in this first half. Bears on top here, 42-3. Now as both teams head of the locker room, we got halftime activities coming. We also have a special guest coming up. We'll hear from one of the Lenore Ryan faithful here as they talk Lenore Ryan Athletics. Jeremy Zalaka, he is the vice president of athletic communications. He will join us at halftime. We'll talk LR sports and more surprises. Who knows? Stay with us.
This once-in-a-generation project will give student-athletes an advantage and position Lenore Ryan as a leader in academics and athletics.
Plus, and $350 off the Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra. The great savings continue with 4 lines of unlimited data for just $35 a month per line. Celebrate great savings and go stay connected wherever your travels take you.
Paramount Kia in Hickory. We want to see you driving a new Kia or, hey, a quality pre-owned Kia. We've got a huge selection of new and pre-owned Kias. You got to get to Paramount Kia in Hickory, Highway 70, ParamountKia.com.
2 hours from right now, so we're hoping this second half goes pretty quick so we can get everything inside for the basketball game.
So you get preparing for this game here today and some of the other sports, but I want to talk about this game. What are you hearing in the region in terms of if LR is able to win big today, and they're obviously off to a great start here at halftime, 42-3. What are you hearing about regional teams, and should things shake out the way LR wants them to with a win here today and maybe a Mars Hill loss at Wingate? What is your forecast on what the playoffs might look at?
Sure, I think we got two big ones today that we got to root for, and one of them is a win over Bowie State would really help their cause, so we can't have that happen. And then we want, unfortunately, we got to root for a Wingate today. So for the second week in a row, we're trying to get a Wingate win for us. It'll be on at 4:30. They're a brand new team. They got a lot of new pieces. Basically, that's the story for both our basketball teams. A lot of new pieces, a lot of new faces and new places. So just to see how they'll adapt. I think both teams got picked in the middle to bottom part of the league. So they'll just have a lot to prove. And preseason predictions are hard enough, let alone with all the roster changeovers now and the abbreviated year last year. So I think they got to just go out and prove it to themselves that they're going to be able to compete in the league.
And for fans that are listening or even watching on the stream, the chance to come over here and watch the historic Shuford Gymnasium with a little bit of a new look when they come in.
Sure, we got a new look out there. We're going to have a new look out here, just a new look LR. And it's been an awesome time, and it's been really exciting. So this is a great spot to be, and I feel lucky and blessed to be able to be here.
All right, buddy. We appreciate you coming on board. And, new look LR. Maybe
for sure.
That might be a name of a T-shirt someday down the road.
I got to give a quick shout-out to my son Mason, who's watching on the stream.
Okay.
Hopefully he kept his attention span this whole, five-minute interview to stay to the end. But got to give a shout-out to the little man.
All right. JZ, thank you as always, my friend.
Appreciate you, Juju.
Go Bears. All right.
Thanks.
Anytime. Jeremy Zelacka, Vice President of Athletic Communications for Lenoir Ryan, joining us here at halftime. Jack, down on the field at halftime, it's Letterman's Day here today, and quite a contingent of Lenoir Ryan veteran Letterman out there today.
Yeah, and as I looked, I saw them from every category, all the way up to fairly recent players, and that's what's great to see. The old-timers like myself always love coming back, and there were a number of them. Top has had very, very little going with the rushing game at all, you know.
Second down and 11, just underway here in the second half. 11:43 to go here in the third quarter. Stewart, they're going left to right. They're going to the closed end here at Moret Stadium. And here's a pass over here, and it looked like LR's guy was intended over there, and it falls incomplete. Third and 11.
Yeah, he tried to bring the inside, let the tight end slip out, and then bring that inside outside receiver back across and just curl him in there about 7 or 8 yards down the field and get rid of the ball quick. It's smart what they're trying to do. They know that if they get deep in the pocket, we'll get a good pass rush on them. It's hard to stop our pass rush, but, you know, they're trying to get throws where they can go three-step or five-step and get the ball out of his hand quickly.
Third and 11 now. Indians will send four receivers out. In the shotgun, Stewart back, takes a deep drop, dumps it off on a screen to the running back. Shoestring tackle by Joseph. Shy of the first down on the reception. And tackled is Von Ramsey, but not before a nice play by Joseph, the veteran Bear defensive linebacker.
I don't know if Preston Joseph will make all conference, but statistically he's going to be up there.
He's steady.
In terms of tackles. But he makes play. He has great vision. He reminds me of Kyle Duggar a little bit, but playing a different position. He saw that play. I happened to be looking at an angle where I could see him. He recognized that play. He was almost 7 or 8 yards deep in the backfield, you know, in the defensive backfield, when he saw that play, and he just made a bullet line right straight up there and made a heck of a tackle.
He might remind you of Kyle because they played the same position when they first got here. Joseph was here's a pass down the end zone on fourth down, out of the end zone, incomplete. Joseph was a safety, Jack, when he first came to LR, and they moved him up to linebacker a few years ago.
Yeah, well, I tell you what, he's a good one. And, you know, and the way defense is played nowadays, you know, you're not seeing the power eye formation where you got to have linebackers that weigh 240 pounds. You know, you got to have some guys at linebacker that can run. You know, they're going to have to play the run at times, but a lot of the runs are outside runs. And a lot of these, the runs you see out of the spread formation are not power type things where there's, you know, like we used to see in the I formation, things like that, when the linebackers had to be big and strong.
And you have to tackle in space. And
exactly.
You have to have speed.
Which is what he just showed you.
Yeah. So the Bears take over on first down, and they run it up the middle to McGee. And Dwayne gets it up to about the 29. And McGee in that first half, and he's trying to get over 100 yards. That should put him over 100 on the night. That's his 14th carry. That should put him up at about 104 yards, averaging 7.5 yards, but had a big run. Was kind of bottled up before a 65-yard touchdown run late in that first half to give the Bears a score. So it's second down and short. McGee gets it again, running right. He's hemmed up right at about the 31. It's going to be shy of a first down, bringing up third and short.
Yeah, if Coach Jacobs has got a goal this half, it's to get McGee a bunch of yards if he can. It would be just great for him to get that record for the LR school record for yards in a season, because he has really earned every one of them. He takes a lot of hits for a 170-pounder.
Third down and short, McGee lines up in an eye. Right behind Willingham, who's under center this time, sends a man in motion left. Turn, hand it, McGee following his blockers, has the first down, cuts outside to the 40 and to the 41-yard line. Big play of about 11-yard run by McGee. He is really good. You mentioned his vision. That time he followed his blockers, Jack, to perfection in front of the Catawba bench and picked up a Bear first down.
Yeah, he just has the ability to move laterally, quickly. It doesn't take him long to make a move, you know, to plant that foot and make that quick move. But he does it so effortlessly. You just don't see him look like he's straining to do anything. Everything looks so easy watching him do it.
Tight end Cody Osborne out of Windsor, Florida, or Windsor, Ohio, limps off the field. Here's a swing pass to Davis, and he scoots out of bounds into Catawba territory at about the 46. Just took a little swing pass. And Jadis Davis, who has a burst of speed, Jack, and he gets to the around the edge and on a screen pass gets about 20 yards into Catawba territory at the 46.
Yeah, Davis, when you put Davis in there and McGee together, you know, one's in, one's out, and sometimes they're both on the field at the same time. And I would expect next year we'll see a few more situations where they're both out there at the same time.
Davis only 5'10", 1'8".
He was through that hole and up the field before you know it. And this style of offense you wouldn't think would be good for a smaller back but they've adapted the style. Coach Jacobs and Coach Soto have adapted the style of running plays to the backs that we have, and they do a great job.
Two tight ends set. Here's a quick pitch. McGee back in, takes the pitch, going left side, follows his blockers and run out of bounds. You know, the Bears use two, three tight end sets quite a bit, Jack, different formations, and a good block on the edge. You sealed it over there was backup tight end Will Martin, redshirt freshman out of Burlington, Western Alamance High School. And McGee picked up about 6 on the play. Second down, 7:47 to go in the third. Bears on top here, 42-3 over rival Catawba. Willingham looks to the sidelines.
And it's been pretty much outside the little flip pass to Davis out of the backfield. It's been pretty much all run this until there.
And a pass incomplete. Intended over there for Parsons. Little out pattern, I guess, or stop route. And he threw it low, and Parsons went down to get it. Good coverage by the Indians, and complete third down and 4. Third and 4 now for the Bears.
You know, that was a route. I didn't understand it, really. He went down there and kind of just turned to the outside and stopped. Usually, if he'd have broke to the outside, I think he'd have been wide open. But
maybe he's setting him up for this play.
It had to be a call route because Grayson threw the ball exactly where he needed to throw it for that right, for a little turn outside.
There's a running play to McGee following his blockers left-hand side, has the first down inside the 20 and flipped out of bounds to the 17. That time McGee followed those blockers left side, short side in front of the LR bench and has another LR first down.
Yeah, Davis back in there now. They're going to put Davis and McGee in at the same time. This is what I like to see. You know, this is where the imagination comes in. Both of them going to be in the backfield. All right. This is interesting. Now, this is the kind of thing that could be formidable next year. You still got three wide receivers with those two guys in the backfield.
Davis goes in motion. They hand it up the middle to McGee. He has a space, and into the end zone he goes. Dwayne McGee gets his second touchdown, 19th touchdown of the season, I believe. And the Bears are on the board again. It's 48-3 with 6:51 to go here in the third quarter.
And that's what happens when you put Davis in there. And McGee, see, he flared Davis, and it looked like he was going to run that little route where we flipped it to him, and then he just turned and handed it to McGee, and, well, everybody was gone. Nobody there. I don't think anybody challenged Dwayne all the way to the end zone there. That should give him that's two today. That's 19 for the year now.
Amazing. And the extra point tacked on again. The Bears tack on a score. 6:51 to go in the third. And the route is on. It's LR 49 and Catawba 3. Stay with us as we step aside. This is Lenoir-Rhyne football. Tell you what, Jack, when you look in the history book, and you and I have looked at the history book probably more than anybody else, LR football fans, McGee for the Bears has a chance to rewrite some of the rushing records, and some of those rushing records have stood for a very long time.
You go way back and you can really You go. I had my microphone in the wrong place. You go way back in the stats, and you can really find some. Wow, he got through there again. You can really find some records of some, you know, some guys that have started off well. But I don't know if anybody's ever started off as a freshman quite as well as this. This could be the freshman record, and I know there's been a lot of good ones have come through, because LR has been, you know, was always known as pretty much a rushing team. Then we had a little stretch here where we had some Lauren Deans and people like that, and we threw the ball a little bit more, became more of a passing team. But if you go back to Coach Stasevich and the single wing and all the way up through there, it was a running football team. Always been a lot of good running backs come through this university. And, you know, McGee's a good one. Davis is a good one. I mean, I'm excited to see what they're going to do with both of them next year.
There's a pass on first down after the kick return up to the 31. Completed pass, gain of 5 on the play, second down and 5. And what's amazing that McGee has done this in a 10-game season. And as a freshman, he has a chance to score more touchdowns than anybody in one season and most rushing yards in a season. Well, and we still have a quarter and a half to play.
Yeah, you know, some of the records, if you go back far enough, some of the records were in 10-game seasons back in the day of the single wing. And when I was here, 3 of the 4 years I was here, we didn't play but 9 games, because 10 was all you could play, and we couldn't get a 10th game. So, you know, there's a nice little reverse jet sweep. But, you know, when you do it in 9 games, like Mike McCree and Carl Bartles, you know, 2 of the years that they played when I was here, they only played 9 games. You know, go look at their stats in 9 games.
Yeah.
You know, if you go to a per-game average, it starts looking better. That's what a conference has had to do this, to go to, awarding not on total yardage but on per-game average, because we're going to play 10 games. Some of them are going to play 11 games, okay? And Catawba's only going to play, what, 9 or 8 maybe?
Yeah.
You know.
And so right now, the Indians, while we were away, got a first down, and here's a pass into LR territory. And again, this a little scat back wide receiver, Kawan Pryor, had a nice run for a first down out of Cherryville and Burns High School product. And this time just hauls in a nice little pass out of the flat, and into LR territory go the Indians as they're down to the LR 40 with another first down, first and 10. 5:16 to go here in the third. Bears on top, 49-3, couple of scores.
Barton was the final. Barton's 36-24. That's a final over Wise.
Okay,
thank 36-24.
So Barton finishes the season with a winning record. First full season. I think they finished 6-5.
And mostly freshmen and a few sophomores mixed in. That's going to be a team to be reckoned with for years to come.
And they'll be in our division starting next year.
And they've got a veteran coach, Chip Hester. Chip Hester coached at Catawba for a number of years and had Catawba, near the top of the league a lot of the time.
Was the head coach at Catawba before, I believe, Curtis Walker. He was on the staff at Catawba for a while, and the current Catawba coach is in Catawba's Hall of Fame and played for Catawba back in the early 90s.
I think you're correct.
Was an assistant coach at Western Carolina before he took over the job as head coach for the Indians back in 2013, I believe. There's a running play right up the middle, and the Bear front line is back in there. Some of those guys, Amari Houston in on the stop for the Bears.
Bowie State's still 14-0. That game hasn't changed.
Devin Hibbett is in at linebacker, freshman out of Bedford, Ohio. In on the stop. Third down and short now.
Georgia's up 41-0 on Delta, so that one, we can pretty much mark that one down as done there.
Yep. West Georgia under their veteran coach, David Dean. I believe he coached at maybe Valdosta State.
Pick.
Nope.
Oh, man.
There's a flag on the play. It's going to go against the Bears. A little pass play out in the flat over there, and Percy King may have had a hand on the wide receiver, so it's going to be a penalty against the Bears and a first down for the Indians.
Yeah, the bad thing was, Percy, what he didn't recognize was the ball was so far overthrown. If the guy had been, 7'3", he probably could have got a hand on it. But at 5'6", he didn't even come close to catching that ball. Percy tried to cut in front of him and hit him, and that's where the penalty was called.
Bears have played over 4.5 games now. And have only given up one touchdown.
Yeah, that's amazing. Pretty well shut the door on team scoring. You know, and of all the teams we played, some of them haven't been as good. But I'm going to tell you one thing. That game at Wingate, when we went down there and shut them down like that, that game really impressed me. That's when I thought we'd really turned the corner. You know, Barton was more of a scary game for me because I knew they had a running back and I knew they had a quarterback that had given us fits. Newberry and Wise both beat us with a good running back and a running quarterback.
Yeah. Playing with a lot of confidence right now and a lot of swagger, this team is. First and 10, Indians. Passes.
Intercepted
by one of the defensive linemen.
Threw it right to him.
Hit him right in the gut.
There he is. 89?
No, that's
99.
Good play by Cam Gordon, freshman out of Greenwood, South Carolina.
I mean, it hit him right in the stomach. Not in the head or the shoulder. It hit him in the stomach. That ball was, I don't know what Stewart was throwing at to throw the ball that low. But, you know, I've been through seasons like Catawba's had. You know, that's what happens. You got things going. You're looking pretty good, and all of a sudden your quarterback throws the ball and hits the defensive lineman in the stomach. I mean, that just happens when things are going bad.
One defensive lineman scores a touchdown for the Bears today, playing halfback, and another gets an interception.
Now, how many times are you going to see that?
Not much. First and 10 Bears, 30-yard line. Running left with it, taking the little pitch. Little jet sweep action.
Is that 18?
Can't tell, 18 or 10.
18. Danny said it's 18. If Danny says it's 18, book it, buddy.
Sunga Yates, yep. Freshman out of Charlotte and Vance High School. They got a couple of guys on that team from Vance. Wide receiver Jordan Payne is from Vance High School as well.
Let's see if we go to the outcut over here.
Loss of 7 on the play. 6, second and 16. Straight handoff up the middle. McGee trying to find a hole. Scampers over the 35 to the 36. Nice pickup for McGee. It's going to bring up now third and six now. Gain of 10 on the play.
That's going to put him close to 160 yards, 163 yards now.
I think, Danny, he needed 168 to break the record. I think. Okay.
Well, he's at 163 right now.
Third down now. Back to pass, Willingham. Grayson's got all kind of room, and he's going to run with it. Tucks with it.
Get down.
And he does.
There you go.
He didn't go down on his own volition, though. He kind of got forced down, but he got the first down. Good run by Grayson.
If he slid, he didn't get the first down if he slid.
No.
Because he was going to be a little bit short. So that was a good play on Grayson's part. Grayson hasn't run much, and you can see he's not fleet of foot, but he can run enough that in crucial situations, you know, he can make a play for you, and he just did it.
We talked to him this week, and he said, hey, I got more weapons, even though he's got two or three guys that are still hurt, including Derek Young. He said, I got more weapons I've ever had before. Here's a running play.
Look at that little rascal.
A tackle, and you're right. He gets 2 yards out of nothing.
And he got hit about 2 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Oh, he's amazing.
He's at
163 before that carry.
They're going to give him 3, so second down and 7.
He's at 166 now. If you think it's 168, then we're in great shape.
All right, so we're close. He's close to breaking Leonard Davis's record that's been held since 1994.
That might give it to him. That might be 3. 1, 2, 3.
It's close. Yep. One more carry should do it.
Well, this should be 169 right now if they gave him 3. Let's see.
That's third down.
Hey, who's an official statistician up here? Jeremy?
Yeah, JC.
Come on, Jeremy. Give him a yard.
Third and 4. No, he needs one more yard.
169. He's got it.
Okay.
That's net now. You know, he could lose a yard or two here and go back, you know. He's had some negative plays before, but not many today.
They're giving it to him, and he has a big gain this time at the 40. Gets a nice block by Sumner down the field.
Cuts back
to the 30, down to the 25-yard line. That's a gain of 26. Dwayne McGee. That'll keep him the record.
Yep, and there comes Jadis Davis in. Wow, that is so impressive, Juju. And I guess I've seen every carry this year. He just continues to amaze his ability to run. That time we just blocked him. He didn't have to do a lot of running here. We blocked him. That offensive line did a great job right there. End of the quarter.
End of the third quarter. So the Bears got a couple of scores. At least one score in that third quarter. We go to the fourth. It's all Bears. It's LR 49 and Catawba 3. Back with the fourth quarter. Stay with us. This is Lenoir Ryan Football on WSVM Radio. Back here, Juju Phillips, along with Jack Huss, as we start the fourth quarter of play. Bears on top, 49-3.
Wayne McGee for a game of 6, second and 4.
McGee picks up 6 on the play, second down and 4. He's now shattered the single-season rushing record set by Leonard Davis back in 1994. also, coincidentally, play 10 games, regular season games. So McGee is on pace to add to his mark, and he does. He runs the football up the middle, gets down inside the 20, out of the 16, going to bring up third and short now. Just underway to start the fourth quarter. The Bears are led from the outset, 49-3. We got a couple of final scores, or close to finals. Barton knocks off Virginia Wise, 36-24. And it is West Georgia leading Delta State 41-0. Tusculum on top of Carson Newman, 14-0. But the big game we're watching just underway, Mars Hill at Wingate. That game, we need a Wingate victory to knock off Mars Hill for the Bears to have any chance to make the playoffs this afternoon. Here's a handoff, McGee up the middle. He'll get down to the 14, and that's good enough for another LR first down.
And your situation now is, I wonder if there's a record for touchdowns, rushing touchdowns. Is there a record for that?
I think.
Because he's got
19.
What did we say, 19? That's a lot of rushing touchdowns. Thing about it, they just took him out. You know, you're kind of in a situation here. You know, if we knew we were in the playoffs, I think Willingham and McGee and a lot of these guys would be on the sideline right now, you know. But we don't know for sure that we're going to make the playoffs. So, you know, he's leaving some of those guys in there to get their last taste.
And there's a running play on first and 10. And the Bears are going to the closed end here at Moret Stadium. They call it the south end of Moret Stadium. And that's over on the far left side, a short pickup, maybe – slight loss on the play, second down. And, you know, most of Moret Stadium now with the press box is now in shade, and they're on the sun side of the field over there.
Nice and warm over there.
Yes, a little bit warmer, yeah.
Danny looks like she's from Nanook of the North over here next to
in the next booth. Here's a handoff, Davis, and he's running left. No, not much running room. He spun down and knocked down a gain of two on the play. Gain of one, actually, third and eight.
Kane Cruz comes in. Last week, almost every time he came in, or in preceding weeks, it was some type of pass play, and they put Kane in there. He's the best blocker. He's a little bigger and more stout. They used him for blocking. But then earlier in the game, we saw him come out of the backfield as kind of a decoy, because we knew most of the time the defense will see 20 come on the field, and they say, well, it's a pass play.
Third down and eight, back to pass, Willingham. He dumps it off inside to the five, down to the 4-3-2-1, and into the end zone.
34.
That's Malik Sumner out of Hickory High School, red tornado freshman.
Wow. I'll tell you what, that's a good looking run with the ball. He just kept running and just ran through him.
Malachi Sumner with the touchdown.
Let's see.
Just a crossing pattern. He's been really good on the special teams this year. Had a big hit in that Tusculum game that caused one of the late turnovers on that muff punt. And, boy, I tell you, that time his first touchdown as an LR Bear.
And that puts Willingham up to 21 touchdown passes. Now, Wise quarterback, Redwine, has 22, and I'd bet he got a couple today. So Willingham may not catch him for second place. Urswa. Is that the way you pronounce it?
Yeah.
Quarterback from Mars Hill?
Mm-hmm.
He's got 23. So he's probably he may have fallen behind Redwine from Wise now for the touchdown, passing touchdown lead.
55-3 now. Why would you call it delay game on the defense when it's a 55-3 deficit?
I think we're going to see some of the second unit guys in there now. I don't know if I'd want to take a chance just in case you make the playoffs. Willingham's had a fantastic career, and you know, anything you do now is not really, you know.
And some of the backups are warming up on the sideline as you say that, Jack. Yeah. Right in front of us, Gunnar Anderson and one of the backup centers snapping it to him, and I'm sure he's getting ready, as Jake Patterson, redshirt freshman out of Zebulon, Georgia, Pike County High School. Extra point is up and good. Another guy's been busy this season, and his right leg's been busy in his career as Chase Alba.
Yeah, he's about worn out now. He said 56 last week and 56 this week. That's 112 in two games. And he's kicked all the extra points. Now I'm going to say something, because I don't want to jinx. I wasn't going to say it earlier. And everybody talks about Chase Elby. Oh, that's a, you know, all these extra points in a row. Somebody snapped that ball.
Yeah.
Somebody held that ball. And they never screwed up.
Never did.
You think about that many snaps, okay? And I know Holden Strong, I believe, is the snapper now. But he wasn't probably – has he been the snapper all the way through? I don't know. I can't remember who that might have been the snapper.
I think
not Holden Strong, excuse me. Tyler Keaton's the snapper.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he has a brother that plays on the team, too.
Yeah. But if Tyler Keaton or Michael Owen, you know, screw up a snap or a hole, that record goes by the wayside. I mean, the people that held, the people that snapped for all of Chase's extra points, they deserve a lot of credit for that. Now, Chase is the one that had to kick them through there, don't get me wrong. But somebody had to snap it and somebody had to hold it.
Greatest team sport alive.
You got it.
Here's the kickoff to the 15-20, trying to find some space and a big tackle. Bears meet up the return man. And a good tackle by the Bears that time is K.J. Makins. The defensive back, a freshman out of Greenwood, South Carolina. You know, both teams have players from Greenwood, South Carolina on their roster. Must be a hotbed of football, Jack.
Yep. Oh, Greenwood. Yeah, absolutely. Pinky Babb, wasn't that where Pinky Babb coached for so many years? They were just producing football players right and left. Let's see. It looks like Houston's still in there.
That's not too far from Spartanburg, is it?
It's actually closer to Erskine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Anderson, yeah. Over in that area.
Yeah.
Boy, look at this little rascal.
Yeah.
Wow, can he run.
Running with the football and a nice run. He is the backup. Or Pryor, he is actually the wide receiver.
Yeah.
They had him in there, and Pryor.
Well, that was the little jet sweep. They've run it to a couple of times.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, I'd get the ball in his hands. He's giving us fits on kick returns and from the line of scrimmage.
And a 5'6 redshirt freshman out of Cherryville, Burns High School.
So he's out now. They had him in there for that one play to do one thing.
Keeps the clock running. 11:20 to go in the ball game. Bears up 56-3.
New quarterback, number 17.
And he dumps it off here. Pass is incomplete and a big hit. Dante Young coming in and blowing up that play. The pass was bobbled by the receiver, and Young just blew up that receiver right there. Neil Young, out of Florida, transfer from University of Texas, El Paso.
Wow. Billy Alton.
Yeah.
So Billy Alton was offensive coordinator and then took over. The coach got fired 2 games in, and Billy took over as the head coach for the rest of that season.
Former Lenore Ryan
assistant.
That's
number 17 that's not showing on their roster. The one that I see on the roster that was on their program today shows number 17 is Robert Cherry, a defensive lineman, 6'3", 240. I don't think that's him playing quarterback.
Yeah, I think that's number 12 back in there, though.
Is that 12?
Okay. Is it 12 or 17?
It looks like 17.
It does.
It could be 12. There's another sack. It's 12. Yep.
One of the Bear players is down on the play.
Look how big those numbers are. I love those numbers.
Luba is going to get credit with the sack.
Is that Luba down?
No. It is not down. And one of the guys, I believe, that is defensive lineman Josh Davis. He's a freshman out of Jacksonville, Florida.
Is that 44?
It is.
Yep.
Let's step aside. No, we'll keep it right here because the Bears are on top here.
I promise you, Catawba doesn't want to stop the clock.
No.
And the Bears probably don't either right now.
56-3. Bears on top. Luba stays in, Lane in at defensive end. Being joined up front by the Bears, I believe that's Shelton. And.
Yeah, Houston's out.
Jefferson up front.
93. DeAndre Shelton.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's pretty much the starting defensive unit for the Bears.
Oh, man. Pick. That's got to be a pick.
Yeah,
you can't let him catch that ball.
And he caught it.
You cannot let him catch that ball.
And he caught it. What a nice catch in jump ball territory. Jaden Lockhart, freshman out of Charlotte, taking the completed pass from Brandon Stewart. It just lofted it in the air. Is the old alley-oop?
I mean, that was throw it up. All right, here it is, guys. Somebody catch it. And please be on my team.
I was watching defensive lineman Dan Luba. Jackie dropped in coverage. Playing like middle linebacker.
Yeah, they dropped. You remember the the lineman intercepted. Yeah. That's what he did.
Yeah.
He dropped back and covered that little middle area right there, and that's what a quarterback didn't expect that, and he threw it right to him.
First down, 32 of LR. Sweep right. Bears come up and meet him. Still running with the ball. Good hard run by the Indians. Von Ramsey. Ramsey will get about two on the play. Luba on the stop. A couple of different players had a chance, and he broke a couple of tackles. A run of 2 yard gain, second and eight. 9.5 to go here in the ball game. Bears are going to win this 100th meeting between these rivals. Dates all the way back to 1907, where they played three times in one season.
Mm-hmm. It's only three games of the season, too.
Here's a reverse. Bears nearly had him in the
Amari
backfield.
Amari Houston almost got him.
Yes, indeed. And it's that little scat back, and he runs with the football again. That's Pryor. Make a couple of jukes, and he'll gain two.
He adds some excitement to the football game, I'll tell you that right now. Amari Houston had him about 7 or 8 yards deep in the backfield, but Amari against that guy when it comes to speed and quickness, and, you know, as good as Amari is and as quick as he is, that's still not a matchup.
Third down now for the Bears, 3rd and 7. Big thank you to our sponsors all season. Carolina West Wireless among them. Proud to be the official wireless provider for LR Athletics. Back to pass, Stewart. He'll throw it left side.
He floated it up again.
And he caught the football. No.
He dropped it out of bounds.
He fell out of bounds. He had it for a second. Boy, nice catch. Would have been a nice catch by Lockhart, the freshman out of Charlotte. But they call it incomplete, so 4th down. Still the Bears have kept the team out of the end zone today.
Yeah, Makins has been picked on the last couple of plays. He's the one that let the guy catch that little floater, and he almost let him do it again.
Yeah.
He's not playing the ball. He's not seeing the ball. That's the hardest thing for a defensive back, too. You've got to see the ball. Aaron Foster, the defensive back coach, has done a real good job this year. Really, we've gotten a whole lot better on those corners than we were early in the year.
That was a pass over here, incomplete. Had enough of the first down, but the Bears knock it away.
Blakeney.
Yeah, Blakeney. It was intended for Singleton. Would have been enough for the first down, but as you said, Blakeney knocked it away. So the Bear offense will take over on downs. And had about an extra year of eligibility to be a graduate student next year. And if he would, he'd maybe vie for the starting quarterback job in the spring.
Yeah, and he's won some big games. He beat Newberry twice, didn't he, in his career, starting for Willingham when he was injured. Didn't he? He went down there with in Chronic's first year.
Yeah, he did. Grayson had, not I would say the mumps, he had mononucleosis.
Okay.
And he missed a couple of weeks, and Grayson went down, and thanks to Kyle Duggar's 2 punt returns, that helped. He generaled the Bears as first ever starting assignment as a quarterback, as a freshman. Didn't make mistakes, and the Bears came back and won that football game at Newberry and went on to win the conference championship back in 2018. So yeah, he's had some clutch moments in his career for the Bears. And Davis, the running back, has the football, and he'll get it over the 39. Should be enough for a first down. And it is. Another first down for the Bears, who came in averaging, Jack, 40 points a game. They're going to exceed that. They're up to 56 with 6:55 to go in the ball game. They have been averaging almost 500 yards a game on offense. They've done that today. They're up close to that as well. A bunch of different guys have scored touchdowns. 6 or 7 guys have scored touchdowns today. They just spread around the wealth. And here is Anderson on the keeper.
Big first down right there, too, for the Bears. As long as the Bears keep the ball on the ground, which they're probably going to do, then this clock's going to run. You know,
yeah.
As long as somebody's making first downs, the clock's going to run. McGee, 26, Terry's 206 for the day. And that was, 15 yards there early on, and then all of a sudden busted one, and then after that, the gates were open.
65-yard run. That broke that game open for the Bears on offense, at least running the football there in the, late in the first half. Kane Cruz gets the handoff, and he is spun down.
And Willingham, I think he was 18 out of 20 something. He wound up 20 out of 29 for 246. And he had 228 at half. So, you know, 18 yards second in the second half throwing, but we didn't throw the ball.
Yeah.
We didn't need to. We ran the ball, and we threw it in the first half and ran it in the second half. And McGee got his yards. Willingham got his yards, got three touchdown passes.
Last one
McGee
going.
Got two touchdowns. Rushing. Lester a touchdown rushing. And Willingham and Luba.
Second and 11. Cruz takes the handoff from Anderson. He'll get it over the 50. And into the Catawba territory at the 49. With 5:15 to go in the ball game, Bears are going to win this historic 100th meeting between these two schools today. 56-3, Bears on top here, and awaiting the results of today's Morris Hill at Wingate game that started at 3 o'clock. Should Wingate win at home, it would enhance the Bears' chances of making the postseason in the region as an at-large team in a likely playoff game on the road. Cruz with the handoff, busted up the middle, and he should have enough for the first down. Senior Kane Cruz down to the 40-yard line.
Great job by Kane Cruz. Great job by that second group offensive lineman. They kind of pushed him around in there. And here comes your other running back in there, number 25. That's Jacoby Lane. And I'll tell you what, they don't lose much when Jacoby Lane comes in there. It's our fourth running back of the day, and all of them can help. Of course, Kane Cruz is a senior. He'll be graduating.
So Lane is a true freshman. His brother is a defensive lineman, both out of Florida, and he takes the handoff running right. And he takes a loss on the play of one. Second down and 11. Second and 11, down to 4 minutes to go, rolling clock. 56-3, Bears over the Indians. Head coach Mike Jacobs looking for his 11th win as an LR head coach. And would go to 53-11, Jack, as a head coach in his career. That's a pretty impressive record.
Very impressive record. Coach Jacobs has done a phenomenal job. And I think the coaching staff's done a great job this year, too, making some adjustments and pulling things together.
Lane with a handoff, running right, sweeping right down to the 33. Shy of first down, though, he gets about six on the play.
I think over the course of the season, we've made a lot of adjustments that have gotten things where we felt comfortable doing what we're doing now on both offense and defense. Update. Ball game. They made a ball game out of it here. Boise State 14, Fayetteville State 7 in the fourth quarter.
Third and two. We need Bowie State to win that game, by the way.
Yep.
Here's a handoff to Lane, and he is going to be shy the first down up to the 31. It's going to be about less than a yard, so let's see if the Bears go for it here on fourth and short here. Under 3 minutes to go, approaching 2.5 minutes, and we have another running back coming in, Jack, number 22.
Yeah, he was a kid that played last week. We saw him in there last week later on in the game.
Zy Dillard.
Yeah,
freshman out of Winston-Salem and Parkland High School.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, he looked like the rest of them. He was quick. He darted in and out of there. West Georgia 44-7. That one's got to be getting close to being over.
And he gets the first down. Dillard does, takes the handoff. And that offensive line firing out off the football. A couple of backups in there, and they get another LR first down.
Tusculum 27-7 in the third quarter.
Over Carson Newman, who's going to finish the season with one win, looks like. One win. It's got to be their worst season since Eisenhower's been president, right? Got to go back to the 50s or 60s.
You would think.
Danny doesn't know who Eisenhower is. You want to tell her?
Yeah, she does. She studied history. She studied World War II somewhere along the line.
It's been over 60 years. I know that.
Oh, it's been a huge time. Look at here.
Yep, and there's a sprint through the middle and a running play of big yardage of about 20 yards. And, again, a great run by Dillard, 5'6", 175 pounds.
And that's the I'm guessing that might be the second unit defense in there for Catawba. All right, Albany State 7, Miles nothing, first quarter. That game's supposed to have started at 2 o'clock.
Albany in the region is third. Need them to win. So it is first down, just outside the 10-yard line. Anderson on the keeper. Weaves his way to the five, down to the three, and should get into the end zone. Touchdown.
Nope, no signal.
He's lying in the end zone. He's 5 yards in the end zone.
They got it.
He fumbled the football. That's why the delay was. They were waiting to see who recovered the ball.
Yep.
And the Indians recovered it. With 43 seconds left, Gunnar Anderson on the keeper, got into the end zone, but must have right before he got in, got the ball knocked loose. Indians recover, and the Bears are denied some more points here with 43 seconds to go, leading here 56-3.
That Catawba player, I'm watching him, he's taking that football with him. He said, this is going to be my souvenir. Look at him, he's got that ball. He's not giving it up either.
So we have maybe what one more play here, and that should wrap things up here. 56-3 in favor of the Bears. Danny's got a basketball game. She's got an executive produce over there.
Hey, you
shortly.
Got plenty of time.
You didn't have any hot chocolate up here either,
hey,
Danny.
You got.
We're
you
disappointed.
Got 40, you got 40. You got. The game starts at 4:30. You got 50 minutes. Man, that's no problem for anybody like you, Danny. If it'd been anybody else, I'd worry about it. Is she going to leave us all on her own?
I think so.
Oh, wow. We're in trouble. Nah, you've done this before. I know.
Now, we're going to take a break. And when we take a break, we're going to leave the TV folks, and the radio folks are going to stay with us.
Okay. I got you. Well, we've talked about everybody that makes this program work here.
Yeah.
I don't know if we missed anybody, but if we did, we apologize. Eric Bach and Kendall Lewis, two guys that I work with on the road.
Both of
those young men did a great job for us, and we appreciate them. Pretty hard to fill your shoes, I can tell you that, but both of them did a good job. And Jeremy Zalaka, of course, and Leah Clayton. Leah may not have mentioned her. Leah does a great job in
marketing.
Promotions and things like that. Yeah. And our creative people are just, you know, Danny and Malik and all those people like that and work under Jeremy and everything, Eric. That's just, they're phenomenal. I can't get over how good this thing is.
To be the last play of the game. Kendall Lewis, by the way, is doing a basketball game, I think, Appalachian game today.
Yeah, he does a
ESPN Plus.
Coach Walker was halfway across the field. Why did they stop him? And now he's going back. I don't blame you, Coach.
Now they're going to run the clock. That's it.
Well, the clock was running.
Yeah. And the two coaches have a handshake, and that'll do it, folks. Your final score in the 100th meeting between the Bears and Indians. It was all LR. From the opening gun to the final sound, Bears dominating fashion today. They win it. It's LR 56 and Catawba 3. For you, those of you watching on the TV side, we thank you for watching. As always, we say go Bears. We'll be back in just a second on the radio side. Stay with us. You've been listening and watching Lenoir Ryan Football on the Bears Sports Network.